open this morning for another exciting day of worship. We thank you for joining us this morning. Just one announcement that we do have is we're actually going to try and record worship today. So if things go well and things look good, once Joanne and others look at it Monday morning, then we'll see if we can record this service along with the other one, at least try to take steps towards including both services in our wonderful live streaming online worship experience. So, with that, please prepare your hearts and minds for worship this morning.
I know. my God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from saving me, so far from my cries of anguish? My God, I cry out by day, but you do not answer. By night, but I find no rest. Yet you are enthroned as the Holy One. You are the one Israel praises.
Well, they're not hurting someone else by
telling them. Oh, sure.
eventually, yeah, if you say, hey, you would draw a line.
Yeah, if we didn't have mirrors, we would probably forget what we look like. And then when we did finally have a mirror, we'd be shocked. So, so in the Bible, it tells us how often should we read the Bible?
Every day.
So if we only read the Bible at Christmas time?
No.
If we read it at Christmas and Easter?
No.
And what if we open it maybe once a month?
No.
So it's just like looking in a mirror. If you don't open your Bible and read it, what's going to happen?
You're going to forget the stuff
that's in it. Just like looking in a mirror. If we don't look at ourselves, we're going to forget what we look like. So if you didn't see that big color before, you would not have known what we look like to all these kind of people out here. So if you don't read your Bible, what happens?
You start reading the wrong life, you just learn what to do.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you, Charlotte. Thank you,
John. Yeah, just get out of the way. He's tripping on the bridge.
That's not part of this one.
Yeah.
Good morning, friends.
Good morning.
Continuing life's journey with what some call the new norm with COVID-19. It's masks, not wigs, but masks.
Yeah.
I'm asked often by friends and family and coworkers and church friends and everyone else in life this question. What hope do you have in this time? What hope do you have in this time? What hope do you have in this time? It's a powerful question, a question that can maybe be turned into a sermon and a church lesson. So we'll cover that this morning. Scripture says a lot about hope, a lot. We hear the Old Testament, the New Testament. This morning we're going to focus on Paul's letter to the church of Corinth. Let's hear what he has to say in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 16 through 18. That is why we never give up. Though our bodies are dying, our spirits are being renewed every day. For our present troubles are small and won't last very long, yet they produce for us a glory that vastly outweighs them and will last forever. So don't look at the troubles we can see now. Rather, we fix our gaze on things that cannot be seen. For things we see now will soon be gone, but things we cannot see will last forever. So this morning we're going to focus on three things: reflection, transformation, and hope. So let's start with reflection. For us as Christians, hope is in Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Christ came, Christ taught, Christ sacrificed, Christ came back, and Christ still lives. Amen?
Amen.
Have we lost sight of this, though? With the day and age that we're living in, have we maybe lost sight of that? Hear me out. With everything going on in our lives, in our family's lives, our work lives, our school lives, our church lives, our world lives, have we lost sight of this? Does Christ still live to you today? Reflect as I read another passage from Paul, from Colossians chapter 1, verse 17. Christ is before all things, and in him all things hold together. Reflect on Christ for a moment. Reflect. Reflect on your life pre-pandemic. Reflect on your faith pre-pandemic. Reflect on your focus pre-pandemic. Reflect on your love pre-pandemic. and reflect on where you are right now. Remember the scripture passage we read earlier, 2 Corinthians. That is why we never give up. Though our bodies are dying, our spirits are being renewed every day. In the present day, as you reflect on life, you might find yourself listening to a lot of music and kind of living in the lyrics of some of your favorite bands. One of my favorite bands is the Foo Fighters. While I was putting together this song, or this sermon, this song, times like these came on, and I stopped what I was doing. I listened. I reflected. I found God speaking to me in this song. And hear the words of this song. It's times like these you learn to live again. It's times like these you give and give again. It's times like these you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. And the new day rising, I'm a brand new sky to hang the stars upon tonight. I'm a little divided. Do I stay or run away and leave it all behind? It's times like these you learn to live again. Times like these, you give and give again. It's times like these, you learn to love again. It's times like these, time and time again. Are you learning to live again? Are you learning to give again? Are you learning to love again? It's in times like these that we reflect on this. No matter what's going on your mind, in your body, in your soul, you cannot give up. Are you learning to live again? Are you learning to love again? Are you learning to give again? You can. Your spirits are being renewed each day. Reflect and remember the sacrifice Christ made for you, for each and every one of you. Are you learning to live again? Are you learning to give again? Are you learning to love again? And I might add, are you living hope again? Now let's look at transformation. In verse 17, for our present troubles are small and won't last very long, yet they produce for us a glory that vastly outweighs them and will last forever. Are you going through a transformation right now in your life? I love to hear and use the phrase, the new norm. What the heck does that mean? I like to define it as looking for good. Any situation you come across today, look for that good. And that mindset will transform you. For Paul, it's all about mindset. A Christian is someone with an extraordinary, unusual, unconventional, nonconformist way of looking at things. Amen? Kind of. For followers of Jesus, transformation is the way of life. No matter your situation, no matter what is going on, you matter to Christ. The Gospel of John, the 16th chapter and the 33rd verse. I have told you all this that you may have peace in me. Here on earth you will have many trials and many sorrows, but take heart, because I have overcome the world. Maybe your reflection has led to a transformation in your life. Hear me out. Maybe things have slowed down a little in some areas. Maybe there's been a reflection on what matters in your life that could transform you in the next chapter. COVID-19 is causing many of us to think about how we spend our time and do life right now. How many of us were consumed by multiple upon multiple activities each and every day? Got it. I'm right there with you. We as humans are social. We're busy beings by nature, so this time alone is kind of like a new novel for us. Maybe social distancing will be part of the new norm, but now concentrate on tasks and items that bring fulfillment and increase joy and peace, particularly those activities that grow your spiritual life, rather than merely doing activities to fill the time. Work to transform. Go back one slide. Please. Go back one slide. There. Awesome. The transformative mindset can turn the world upside down. Think about small acts you can do to brighten someone else's day, even if not personally. There's ways you can work in the digital world. Every drop of water makes up an ocean when added together. As a caterpillar cocoons into a butterfly, where can you transform? Through all of this, know that you matter. No one is a spare part in the mission that Christ calls us to carry out. It takes you and me, each of us, spirit, devotion, discipleship to carry out Christ's mission in this world. No action is too small. Everyone has a part to play, a talent to provide, a gift to share. Imagine what would happen. Every one of us fully devoted ourselves to Christ's mission, even in the current state. Imagine how many lives can be changed through Christ. Imagine the transformation that's possible in you. Imagine the transformation we can do in this world. How or what is God calling you to transform? Hear again from the Psalms, chapter 42, verse 11. Why am I discouraged? Why is my heart so sad? I will put my hope in God. I will praise Him again, the Savior, my God. So we've talked about reflection through the Foo Fighters. We've heard about transformation as we reflect through our current situation. But all of this leads. Hope is defined by Oxford English Dictionary as a feeling of expectation and desire for a certain thing to happen. Have we had this feeling over the last 3 to 4 months? Yes. What does Scripture tell us about it? Again, let's journey back to 2 Corinthians in verse 18. So we don't look at the troubles we can see now. Rather, we fix our gaze on things that cannot be seen. For the things we see now will soon be gone. The things we cannot see will last forever. So we're not to look at the troubles we see now. We're to fix our gaze on the things we probably can't see in our daily lives. And let me get this straight. The things we see and the experiences we have now will be gone sometime. So those things we cannot see will last forever. What is your hope focused on? Each and every one of us have troubles going on right now. Amen?
Amen.
Troubles that affect our hope, whether it's jobs, finances, health, stress, decisions, all that is still there. Those are still on your mind, on your back, and in your heart. But shift that. Shift it back to Christ. Do you hope in Christ? Do you hope in Christ? My hope is focused on Christ. My hope is explored through the Gospels, the Gospel of Matthew. And the 12th chapter says, and his name will be the hope of all the world. As God develops our character in the present, he can be relied on for the future as well. We need to be confident in God. We need to remember that we have peace within us, thanks to the Holy Spirit. We can trust and we can hope, even in the troubling times, thanks to Christ. Don't lose hope in overcoming these things. At times, I almost lost hope. Seriously, I almost lost hope over the last few months. Was I alone in that mindset of thinking? What helped me? Prayer. Just as you see in this image up here, no, that's not me, that's not in this room. Prayer is what helped me. You probably think, come on, give me something I can use, Jason. Give me something I can buy, like toilet paper, wipes, or hand sanitizer. No. Prayer. Prayer that is hope. True prayer is emptying yourself of all that junk on the inside and filling yourself back up with the grace that God truly gives you unconditionally. Prepare yourself inside and let God's hope pour out. And you may have trouble with prayer. Spoiler alert, God knows what's already in your mind. Don't edit your prayer, just say it. So often in our prayer life, we try to say what we think we should say, that God the Almighty would want to hear that. Instead, pray what's actually on your heart. Let hope guide you back. I'm praying that in the midst of pain of crisis, you and I stay confident in God. I pray that we have a hope that builds our perseverance, a hope that builds our character, a hope that grows in each and every one of God's children. I pray that God will use these difficulties to force you to reflect, to cause you to transform, to live with a hope that can overcome anything. Are you learning to live again? Are you learning to give again? Are you learning to love again? At times like these, we need to focus on reflection, transformation, and hope. Gifts, tithes, offerings, again, follow the same COVID-19 restriction process we're trying to do. The offering box is back there. You're more than welcome also to send checks in or to pay through PayPal, or if you're a little bit more advanced, you can set up in your bank account where they can automatically send a check to the church and you don't have to worry about writing a check. So technology is our friend in this time, and we give thanks.
Thank you.
gifts back to you. Those gifts brought in today, those gifts throughout the week, those gifts that may not see you come through all electronic. We give all that to you, Heavenly Father. Use it for your will, your way in this community and throughout your world. In your Son, Christ Jesus' name.